was hoping I could be alone out here in the garden. No one ever comes here in the evening. I want to be here for the stars. I don't want anything, and I don't want to talk anymore. Can I please be by myself? That's all you've done here. Poke, probe, and pry. I've never felt so humiliated before. I just want to be left alone. I don't like around anyone. I get upset when I'm in a room full of people. I get really scared. I almost feel like I can't breathe. I just want to be alone, Doctor. I know you don't really care. You're simply doing your job. Once I'm better, you're through with me. Then it's on to another patient. I'm just like anyone else. You probably haven't cared about any patient in years. That would be unprofessional and unnecessary, burden on your concert science. This is cool. I know what I need better than you. You're not that, you know. You don't have any powers to cure everything. I know what you can do and can't do. Go on, get up here. Relax? How can I relax with you bothering me all the time? If there's another way, I'd like to know how. Is there anything else to you wish to pray of me? No? Good, then good night. I thought you were leaving. Sorry, but I'm busy. I'm killing it. The bearing beauty by killing the ugly. It's an old practice. In reality, it meets all which the soil fits. But few people find the truth as fulfilling. If only you had planned something more useful beans or tomatoes, then the sacrifice might be worthwhile. But flowers, they're more difficult to justify. Frail beauty, that's all they have. Cultivate for weakness and has very little nutritional value. In the end, they never can satisfy. Always a disappointment as they wither and die. Frail and weak, like frost would snap its neck. So easily smeared by one little insect, the choice is so easy for most. Yes, it's not. I suppose most people don't give it much thought. I know a story of a man who had played which most got useless with. It turned out the weed was a cure for cancer, but the weed was nearly extinct, so no one got the cure. Do you believe in a such thing? Do you believe in anything? Oh, never mind. I guess to you most beliefs are only fables. No one really cares today. They pay you to care. Everywhere it's the same way. People should only fix what's broken. Why? Couldn't you two all just leave me alone? And what's wrong with me before you found me? I was happy at home, alone, shut up from the world, protected. I had to be alone. I had to hide. I had no choice. I had to be the way. I couldn't live like the others anymore. Why you want to know all this? I said I don't want to talk anymore. Leave me alone. I don't have to tell you anything. I'm not a little kid. There's so much you don't know. I just need to be alone. Why can't they leave me alone? But I'm never alone. There's always someone or something around me. Following me, they're always near. Spirits, ghosts, shadows of the past. Ghosts have always been with me. You're my choice. At least not on my part. It just happened. I don't want to believe, but they fortunately don't suffer me. Perhaps the whole Indian woman read to me. I lived in her house too long as a child. At night, my footstep passed the ceiling, over and over, an invitation march, forever in depths, to a silent run. If only this had been my only encounter, I could dismiss it. The house is settling, my mother said, but it wasn't all the house there. Lights dim and glow. No ghostly was stronger than the new world magic conjured by GE. I slept in my room. Well, not really sleep. Sleep was never something I read much of, especially early on. My worries at 7 far outweighed my need for sleep. Awake, forever awake. My father had left me. My mother. I was always worried my mother would leave me too. I wish the ghost would cool, but they linger. always lingering, never really going. The old Indian woman was my first. She looked at me beside, blue white. My eyes met hers, her eyes giving me a worried look, as if I were the one to explain. Fear making my head sink deep into covers. My eyes untouched by my lips. How long she lived, I'll never know. My dawn, I ventured a look. She was gone, or perhaps she was never there, thinking the apparition a dream. I took my family, and their eyes attracted them. I just ignored her. One had a vision. She didn't go servant. A servant, a girl that year. She had her side. At her side, looking at the girl that I wish I could have been there for her too. Spirits told me, just when I no longer believe, they appear. Flashing lights, a cool touch, the rhythm, even though. But this time it was too much, another place, another spirits. This time it was someone I knew. It started with the call, the news that she had gone away, finding myself in tears, tears sipping my dry. What the tears ever stop, when like a thick metal ball stopped up your eyes. I lost everything, an emptiness replaced love, and serious to find. Nothing there, nobody anyway. But there, with something, somebody opened the doors. Something living, tissue by the bed, the dog breaking at nothing, but something, finding things in new place. Things missing, the locked door open. Explanation fly, knowledge of protection. It began with the cold, spots of cold, a moment of no more than cold, as if the heat was sucked into other dimension. This don't bore me as much as they touch. A handless touch of nothing. Something grabbed by my arm, but no one was there. I ran for bed, buried myself in covers, and waited for dawn. You're never too old to hide under covers, wrapping yourself into a cocoon, hoping that when you emerge alive, you'll be butterflies again. But only children believe in butterflies. Adults know or learn that life's full of moths, caterpillars, and worms. But when I'm alone, first sitting, I wonder, do I really want to be alone? Maybe their visits comfort me. Was it you that touched me that day? And if you are still here, why do I feel so alone? Please stay away. She won't visit me if you are here. Please go. Mother? Mother? Is that you? Mother? I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Does you say no one to listen? At least no one was willing to bend. Why are you still here? What's the use of talking if it doesn't do anyone any good? Do you believe in afterlife? Nah. Like heaven and angels and pearly gates, free of all earthly strife. I think it's a lot less divine than that. I think maybe we all end up a part of a greater world, a teeny molecule in a bigger being, or a little star in a vast universe. With a reason to where we came from. Whether it's God, the great spirit, or something else. But I know. That's where we'll be. Ash to dust. Dust to dust. Where we begin is where we end. The earth gives us life through what we eat. And we give the life when we die. The surge is the finish. Rain that feeds the river comes from the sea. To each beginning, there's a definable end. I know it's getting dark, but I don't want to go back inside anymore. I don't like my room. This is where I want to stay. You can't keep me church any longer. The locked doors won't hold me anymore. Did you know, okay? I can fly. I'm leaving all the earthly matters to you. I belong to near a different sun. I wish I hear that star over there. The little one next to Orion. That way I'd never be lonely. It's so free out there. No one can touch you or hurt you. You can simply shine. People don't like it when you shine. That's why stars are up and not down. Humans think the brightness is offensive. My mother is a star now. She always seemed like one to me, but stars don't like it very well where they can't be so anymore. I want to be a star. Stars having meaning. Stars I understand. Now the star up there in the sky have staying power. I can always count on them. I can always look up and know. They'll be there for me. The stars on earth burn out too quickly. They have a moment where they shine so bright, but then poof, they're gone. A memory, sometimes not even there. But with the stars in the sky, I know they'll be there night after night. Always there for me to make a wish. I make wishes all the time. I wish for the first star each night and say, starlight, star bright, first star I see tonight. I wish I might have the wish I wish tonight. I always make the same wish, but I can tell you what is it. Then it might not come true. I really want it to. It will change my life. I would always go to wishing wells with lucky things. The Spanish you find people have lost. Lucky for them, lucky for me. Then I toast them in the wishing well in front of the old museum. And I toast them in a fountain at the park. Each time making my wish. Have you ever wanted anything that badly in your life? So badly that you can't imagine your future without it? I would be so sad if my life wasn't different. If things didn't change. If I was still stuck here in this life, but I won't stop wishing. I don't want to be left with nothing. I want some meaning, a reason things. My life to turn out this way. I want the suffering to be worthwhile.